Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. In previous lecture, we have discussed briefly about all the basic components of PCR. And we have discussed about DNA template, nucleotides, magnesium, DNA polymerase and primers. So in this video, we will discuss about the characteristics of good primers. We know that we can easily design the primers in our laboratory. So what are basically the primers? These are basically single nucleotide DNA molecules, almost 20 to 30 bases in length. We have also discussed that we have two types of primers, either forward primer, that is 3 prime to 5 prime on sense strand, and we have either the second one is reverse primer, that is 5 prime to 3 prime on anti-sense strand. So we know that we can easily design primers in our laboratory. So what are the basic characteristics or protocols that we have to follow? In this video, we will discuss. So let's start. So the first characteristics is the primer with high GC content. Why? Because we know that the guanine and the cytosine have 3 hydrogen bonds. So it will bind to the template with good specificity and strength. Second, we have adenine and thymine at 3 prime end of primers should be avoided. Why? Because we know that the adenine and thymine have 2 hydrogen bonds. So it will bind to template with weakly. Third, we have primers should bind to template with good specificity and strength. Because when it bind to the template with good specificity and strength, then it can help in DNA synthesis. Next, we have optimal primer sequences and appropriate primer concentration are essential for maximal specificity and efficiency in PCR. Because when we use optimum primer sequence and appropriate primer concentration, it will increase the efficiency of PCR. Last, we have complementary nucleotide sequences within the primers and between the primers should be avoided. Why? Because when complementary nucleotide sequences between two primers use, so it will cause hybridization of primers and also cause primer dimers. And if we use complementary nucleotide sequences within the primers, so it will cause hairpin loop-like structure formation like this. So here we have the characteristics of primer design. By following all these characteristics, we can easily design the primers in our laboratory. That is essential for good specificity and strength for DNA synthesis. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe and share. Thank you and take care.